In this video, I show you how to reduce your lag by using a proxy in Shotcut.
Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at improving the performance of Shotcut by enabling a proxy. So first of all, what is a proxy? Well, put simply, it creates a faster, smaller set of files that are optimized for Shotcut to use. This means that if you have a 4K file and you want to use that but you're struggling, enabling proxy will convert that 4K file into a 360p file for you to work on whilst you're editing. That's a lot easier for Shotcut to handle, and it will mean that you can edit faster and in a smoother way. And if that doesn't make much sense to you, then if you imagine a model toy car, that's a lot easier to pick up, paint, move around, fix, etc., than a real motor car. If you had a real motor car, it's going to take a lot more time, a lot more resource, and by the end of it, you're probably going to be a lot more worn out. If you think of a proxy in the same way, then it's a lot easier to maneuver and to edit and to use a small file than it is a full-size file. So why would you use a proxy? Well, in Shotcut, you might find that the program is lagging or really hard to use because of the quality and size of the file that you're importing. It takes up a lot of processing power and your computer's getting hot. It's not really running the way it should do. Or maybe your computer is actually running fine, but you've got a lot of effects on the screen and you're trying to do lots of transitions and it's just not running as smoothly in the previews as you would like. You may also experience a stuttering at the start of a video clip or in the audio or whenever you press play in the timeline. These would all be reasons to enable a proxy in Shotcut. Now there are a couple of downsides to using a proxy in Shotcut. The first being that it takes up space on your computer. Although the actual file that you're using in the editing screen is smaller, the small file and the original file exist on the computer, so you're actually taking up more hard drive space in total by using a proxy. So you either need to be prepared to store those extra files or clean up the proxies after you've finished editing. You've got the two options there, and we'll go over them in just a few minutes. You will also notice when using a proxy, the quality of your preview pane won't be anywhere near as good, especially if you use preview scaling, which I would recommend using in conjunction with to keep the efficiency and the speed of Shotcut as fast as it can be. So you have to work with a slightly lesser quality image when you're actually doing the edits. Now the bonus of that is that you can flick between the two, you can turn proxy off, etc., and then you get the better quality image. You can also upscale your preview scaling at any point, so you can flick between the two depending on what you need to do, but ultimately you're likely to find that you kind of stay in one mode when you start working on it, and you don't want to have to keep on converting files, etc., whilst you're mid-editing. So that's enough explanation. Let's look at actually enabling a proxy in Shotcut. First thing you need to do is open Shotcut, come up to Settings, go to Proxy. Now, you've obviously got the Use Proxy here. Before you click that, click onto the storage and make sure you're on Project Folder. By using this option, it will store all of your proxied files within your folder location. If you plan on storing your files consistently and you're not going to delete the proxied files, then use this option. It will keep everything in a nice tidy area associated to the correct project. If, on the other hand, you are going to delete your proxied files afterwards, after you've finished editing, then click onto Set and create a space for all your proxied files. What this is going to do is it's going to take your proxied files and put them all in the same place. So it doesn't matter what project you start, doesn't matter how many projects you're in, it's always going to save the proxies to the same folder location. This means intermittently you can go to that folder location and delete all of the proxied files, and it's a nice easy way to collect all of your proxied files together. For me personally, I don't do that, so I'm not going to save a file location there. But on storage, that's exactly how you would do it. So depending on the two options, the two methods that you want to use, once you've set that, tick Use Proxy. Now that saves globally, so the next time that you open Shotcut up, that will also be enabled and it's not going to turn it off unless you turn it off. You can toggle it with F4, so F4 will turn it on or off, just like going to the settings, the proxy, and then selecting it there. So that's great, but what does it actually mean? Well, let's go into a test project and I will show you. So the first thing I'm going to do is just drag some video clips in here. And what you'll notice instantly is that it comes in and over on your jobs pane, it's going to make proxy for bicycle. Okay, so what that means is when you drag it down into your timeline, it says just here that it's a proxy file. If I go to the folder location where I've saved the demo, then you can see that there's a file here now, a folder here called proxies. This is the proxied file. And just to put it into perspective, this is a 2.69 megabyte file. It's only 8 seconds long and it's only HD quality as well, but it's 2.69 megabytes and the original was 25.4 megabytes. Now that's obviously quite a big saving in the size of the file that's being used. And what that means is it enables Shotcut to run much smoother whilst you're editing. Now, if you have an old project that hasn't had proxy enabled on it, but you want to do that, what you can do is you can open it up. And as you can see, if I come onto settings now, proxy, use proxies enabled, but down here, these are not set as proxy. So what you do is you turn proxy off and then you turn it back on once more. And that's going to come up with a pop-up box that says, do you want to create proxies for this project? And you click yes. Over here, it's going to make the proxies. And now if I close that down and reopen Shotcut, go into that project, now the files are proxied. Okay, so I'm only using very small video clips here, but even then the file size and the performance is noticeable. Very well worth doing, and I'd recommend anybody, especially if you're having trouble doing this as default, it will make your editing a lot faster, a lot smoother, a lot more enjoyable, and overall giving you a better experience. Now there's one more thing to understand about proxies, and to demonstrate that, I'm just going to turn proxy off. Now I'm going to drag in a brand new clip and drag it into the timeline. Now, as you can see, none of these are using proxy at the moment, and it might be that you want to have some files proxied and some files not proxied. So to get the best of both worlds, you could have, for example, a small clip that doesn't need to be proxied just because it's small and your computer can handle it, but then a much longer clip that does need to be proxied because the computer is just struggling. To pick and choose the files you have as proxy, you need to have proxy turned off at the start, and then you turn them on for the individual files that you want to proxy. To do that, make sure it's in the timeline, come up to properties, click down here on proxy, and then make proxy. Over in the jobs, you'll see that going through, and then once it's finished, this file is set as proxy, but this file is not set as proxy. So with that in mind, you can try not using a proxy to start with, and if it's getting laggy and it's not working very well, you can turn it into a proxy file and then just work with those files that are causing an issue. So I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.